Hey, this is Sully for H Social News, and this is the Body Count Report for Thursday, October the 12th, 2017. And I'm going to be taking you around the world to show you some life or death news stories that may have been overlooked by a lot of Western media coverage. First up, we have the British jihadi White Widow killed by U.S. drone. So check this out. Sally Jones is no more. Very interesting story here, and got some pictures, a video, all through Ynet News. Thank you for your fine reporting, and we are going to move on. This story link is in the description. Obviously, go check it out. Watch the videos. Can't play it here on my YouTube. It could get flagged for copyright, but we will move along to another story involving Israel. We have UNESCO, which is the which is a UN organization that is apparently not very friendly to Israel. According to the United States and Israel, they are all jumping ship off of it. So there's this sign. All right. Check the video out. Explains it in full what has been going on, why the U.S. is calling UNESCO anti-Semitic, basically. And, yeah, why they're leaving. AfricaNews.com reporting. Thank you so much. Moving on to La Nau del Sur, where there is more mysterious shootings. This is bride's dad shot dead inside mosque, groom wounded. The gunman who, as of Thursday, were unidentified, went into a wedding and shot the father of the bride to death. Horrifying situation. Read it in detail. Writing in Manila Times always really puts you there, so read the story in detail. Incredible. So we hope there's justice for this family. They're in the mosque getting married, and then a gunman rolls in, and two gunmen roll in and shoot up the place. Horrifying. Moving on to Nigeria. We have a very interesting story here on Biafra. Thwarting terrorism in Nigeria, the indigenous people of Biafra must be designated a terrorist group. This is from the Washington Times. Now, I'm including this, even though I like to avoid opinion pieces. I'm including this because we have been talking about Biafra in the past. So, read why this commentator believes that Biafra should, in fact, be looked at as a terrorist organization. And then when you're done reading this opinion piece, very nice, very nicely written opinion piece, alluding to other nativist movements like the PKK with the Kurds. Looks like he's drawing a lot of the comparisons that I came up with. So, interesting. Read this. And then, when you're done reading this, go right back. Go right back to the other side of the planet. Because this is Washington Times, not Nigeria. Jump back to Nigeria. Go back to Vanguard Nigeria and read. If you're really in the mood for reading, enjoy the entire government session. For Thursday, the 12th. There you go. Read that. Also, there's plenty of actual links about Buhari versus Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, leader of the Biafra. Okay, this is it for Thursday, October the 12th, from Israel to the Philippines. That is the body count report for 10/12/17. I hope everybody out there stays safe, and human life is precious. Never forget that.